RHustle Films presents.
Yeah, bitch, call me Shadow. I'm a wild boy, fucking mama, I need hoes.
Yeah, bitch,
call me Shadow.
Yeah, bitch,
call me Shadow.
It's Rittz, dog. What's up, man? This is Rittz, man.
Oh, what's up, man?
I was sitting down with your boy. He was like, "Nah, he's calling right now." I put him on speaker. I was like, "Yo, what's up, man?"
Damn, I was like, "Who the fuck is this?" I'll
put him on the phone with you right now. See you in a little bit.
Trying to show Naptown a little bit of love, man. Getting ready to go open up for Rittz and Yelawolf, the Slumerican tour. Right now I'm walking in with all my artwork and shit. I think I'm about to go tattoo on Rittz tonight, man. We've been talking on Twitter and shit. I'm about to go show him this artwork, maybe get something set up for him, try to knock it out. Build some bridges. I'm tomorrow.
I got a little tattoo shop on the web, man. I brought it, dude. I want to get it.
I just want to get 770 right here, real big, like, you know, just going across.
I'm losing my mind, man, lost in my brain, trading my memories in for no more pain. Losing my faith, baby, it's hard to keep on. There's nowhere else I can turn, no one to lean on. My lifeline is fading, baby, I'm losing my cool. Losing my coffee, the pills are pop just to fool myself into thinking I need to remain haunted by the memory of yesterday. I started to realize there's no more reason. Started to turn into a zombie of treason. I lie to myself and say tomorrow's a new day, and yesterday's dead.
Major labels, they give you advances and shit, and then you end up.
And they own you for the rest of your life.
And you got to pay that money back. They say they're gonna put you on tour. They never put you on tour. Strange moves, merch. You know, it's just.
That's like their angle, pretty much.
It's just Strange is just so fucking. They got their own lane, and there's no creative control over top of it, and they're so organized, dog. And they're just.
That's awesome.
Cool ass group of motherfuckers.
That's awesome. Tech's been working on it his whole fucking life, it seems like.
The only thing that's changed for me right now is just a little bit of pressure, like having an actual date to have things turned in by.
Yeah.
And then right when I got that date, I had to go on this tour, which is 2 months long, so it's like.
How am I supposed to get my shit done if I'm
on
tour?
Yeah, I'm on a real, so when I get back, I gotta have some fucking songs done.
You're right on.
They want like 30-something songs. So they have an EP, an album, and a bonus disc.
Ready to go at once.
By January 31st. And it's like, I get home November 17th, and I ain't see my girlfriend in fucking 2.5 months. So it's like, sorry, baby, but.
I'm still on tour mentally.
Yeah, and yeah. It sucks, man. Because then you come home and you're tired, you really just want to sleep for like 2 days.
And you still ain't got the money to make it more comfortable.
That's yeah, you garbage. Still ain't got the money.
Damn, that would make it a little bit more.
This changed it all. I have money from this tour, but it'll all go right back into me. I'll get a video shot for High Five to push.
I don't mean no money, I just mean you don't get that fucking cushion money.
No, there's no cushion.
Cool, that felt good. Oh, I'm hyped. Yeah, that was the first two times I did those couple, those
hey,
middle
the
two
beat,
songs.
Terrible
Brad B. I've been rapping that song for a couple years, that's my shit.
Midwest motherfucker wild boy,
I'm in that town, proud, hold a motherfucking crown, and I'm probably never gonna put it down, boy. Need a pen of that kush right now, boy. Turned up like a volume dial, boy. If it's too loud, then you're too old to be able to smoke with you with the way put it down, boy. All I wanna do is kill every rapper myself. Follow what I do is smoke every plant you smell. Twisted umbrella to fit to get the pen of smoking to be better, let me get it out by myself. Tatted up my whole city quick. Tatted up my whole city bit. Tatted up like Mr. Cartoon, but I'm something like a mogul, you can call me Diddy, bitch.
Who that is, that shadow?
Who that with a motherfucking tattoo?
There he go, that shadow.
Oh, girl, what's his name?
There he go, that shadow.
Who would've knew that a fuck with a kid rippin' Midwest side of that shadow? Put me in the cutter, better did. Did the damn thing like it figured to be. From the bass to the bump, from the back of the trunk, ain't no, I got my whole damn city with me. From the task to the rap, for the rep, for the nap, ain't no, I got my whole damn city with me. Midwest side to the day that I die, finna get real wild, wanna ride with me.
You did a couple new songs, right?
Yeah, yeah.
What songs did you do?
Did that Call Me Shadow and then Cruising. They're both mixtape joints. One was that Call Me Shadow. It was a remix of the Wild Boy track by, what's his name? And then I did the remix of that Kirko, know what I'm talking about, called Cruising. Man, I was kind of nervous they might not jump on it just because it was remixes of National Shit. But man, that was fucking hype, dude. I felt like every rhyme word, they were fucking with it. If you type, if you go to iTunes and hit Shadowink, S-H-A-D-O-W-I-N-K, I got my shit on there. The song with me and Gucci is on there, Shadowink featuring Gucci Mane. I'm all over YouTube. It's one Shadowink, the number one, and then Shadowink. Damn, I got shit. I still kept the goddamn MySpace up with a million hits on that motherfucker. That's MySpace / Shadowink. It's all over. I got a SoundCloud I ain't really fucked with much yet. And I got a, I'm all over the motherfucker, man, but I'm getting ready to put more effort into the other avenues. Yeah, they reached out to me.
What? How'd that come about?
I think I just did pretty cool on the Tech N9ne show. Was like maybe a year ago. Tech N9ne came out, and I kind of fought for that opportunity because I told 80, which is a promoter, if he got any opportunities with Strange Music. If he got any opportunities with Strange Music, that I wanted to be the first in line because I feel like the Midwest, fuck the Midwest. I feel like NatTown hasn't had much of an opportunity to bring out the artists I like. There was a lot of like the big name
you know, this way or that way, but there wasn't a lot of, like, the Tech Nines, the Yelawolfs, the motherfucking, just that kind of shit, the Rittz, obviously Rittz. So, so I told them to put me in on that one, and I did it, and my people showed love, man. I sold stupid amount of tickets just because they wanted to come out and represent for me and see Tech Nine. So after that, he was like, "Bet, I got you. Next time something that pops up that's related, I got you." So when this show got landed, I was like, "Yo, are there going to be any opening spots?" He's like, "I don't think so." So then, like, a couple weeks before the show, he hits me up and says Live Nation was down. They asked for you specifically. Fucking hit me up. Mixtape I'm getting ready to drop. I've got a full CD called Painkiller that's already done. I'm just kind of been trying to shop some distribution opportunities. I didn't want to just drop it on straight on the internet, but I got mixtape shit I've been doing like a motherfucker. I've been recording fucking night and day, so I'm waiting to drop that shit. Actually, I'm working on that so I can drop that as a preamble to the fucking Painkiller CD. The mixtape will not be all original, but the Painkiller CD will be all original. Everything on there is 100%, and it's all Midwest beat producers, all my engineers from the Midwest, everybody's repping the Midwest, huge. By April of next year, and then I'll have the CD like 2 months after. Yeah. That's my game plan.
Now, as far as your style, like, you develop your style from your own kind of creative side, or did you, you know, like, I mean, obviously you're a fan of like Rittz and Tech Nine and these kind of guy, but is that something that influenced you, or is that just something that just happened to kind of,
yes,
you know,
no,
be in the same lane?
It's ironic you say that shit. Initially, I feel like I was one of the only people in my lane like 8 years ago, 7 years ago. I've been doing the same kind of style forever, and it was too rock for the rap crowd, too rap for the rock crowd, which is what all the promoters told me and all the fucking opportunities I would get. It would either be like I'd be the rapper on a rock show, or I'd be the rocker on a rap show, but I would always like fuck around with all the, I can freestyle with the best of them. I can hold it down on 16s with the best of them. So I kept getting show opportunities. Well, then when I do shows, I get huge opportunities with that. So I'd be like, cool, I put together this kind of show set for this show, or this kind for this show. But the whole time I've always had like a, I got like a poetry side where I do more of like a spoken word, deeper type shit. And then I got my more grimy shit where it's like just rapping real fast. And then I got my, I just got all kinds of different styles. But only as of recently has there been a Yelawolf and a Rittz and a, Tech Nine's always been around, but he was quite a bit older than I was. So obviously his shit was already out. He already had his own style. My shit didn't sound as much like that shit. But now that there is a Rittz and a Yelawolf, my shit kind of fits into that lane, I feel like, more. Banger City on the team. I got Naptown Connection on the team. Man, I've been working on trying to get a pilot episode for this tattoo shop idea. I got the new tattoo shop called Fallen Empire on Emerson and Thompson. I've been working on trying to get the right people interested in doing the pilot. I got a whole pilot kind of written out and a whole angle, whole game plan. Yeah, so I got a couple different angles. I'm hoping to shoot a bunch of shit from that perspective, and then obviously film videos from that perspective so they kind of coincide for each other.
Yeah.
Try to hit the media all at once. Okay. So I'm not just a rapper that tattoos or a tattoo artist that raps. I'm kind of trying to push myself as one whole package.
Okay. For sure.
Mine.
Great job, man. 770 Gwinnett County, Northside, A-Town.